Thoroughbred Week with John Henderson is presented by Adena Springs, Ashford Stud, BC2A Paste, Bloodstock Research, Breeders' Cup, Claiborne Farm, GLC 5500, Gainesway, Horse Sense, Keeneland, Lane's Inn, Malone's, OCD Pellets, Pin Oak Stud, Quillen Leather and Tack, Spendthrift Farm, Thoroughbred Times, Warrendale Sales, and Woods Edge Farm.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Thoroughbred Week, featuring a 1-2 finish for Godolphin in the Dubai World Cup, a regally bred winner of the Grade 1 Florida Derby, and a shocking upset in the Grade 2 Louisiana Derby. We begin with fillies and mares at Gulfstream Park in the Grade 3 Rampart Stakes. Last year's winner, Awesome Maria, the 1-10 favorite. Larry Comas picks up the call.
Around the far turn, Canadian Mistress still on top. Awesome Maria, though, is edging up alongside with 3 furlongs to go. They've picked up the tempo, 3/4 in 1, 10 and 2, and Awesome Maria makes her move, and now she's in front at the quarter pole. Awesome Maria, the leader. Canadian Mistress, second, put to the whip to keep up with Awesome Maria at the top of the stretch. Awesome Maria coming to the eighth pole. Now with a 2-length lead, John Velasquez lets her roll. She's opened up 3. Bellovita catching up to stablemate Canadian Mistress as Awesome Maria comes down to the wire. And Awesome Maria does it again.
Odds on favorite Awesome Maria continues her winning streak by 2.25 lengths over Bellovita. John Velasquez up in 148 flat. The 6th consecutive graded stakes victory for Awesome Maria, who was 4-4 at Gulfstream Park, including an 8-length victory in this race last year. The Todd Pletcher trainee returned from an 8-month layoff to defeat champion Royal Delta by 8 lengths in the Grade 3 Sabine Stakes. The 5-year-old mare by Maria's Mon was bred in Kentucky by Mrs. E. Paul Ropsham. Awesome Maria has earned $992,000 for E. Paul Ropsham Stables, LLC. Awesome Maria paid $220 to win and is the Malone's favorite of the week, presented by Malone's, Lexington's favorite steakhouse. To Fairgrounds for the Grade 2 New Orleans Handicap. Last year's winner, Mission Impossible, the 6-5 favorite. John Dooley has the call.
Nate's Mind Chef leads by a length. Pants on fire. Between horses, 31st Street under pressure. Fast Alex continues a wide strike. Mission Impossible, 2 lengths in back of Nate's Mind Shaft as they come past the quarter pole. And now they're at the top of the stretch. 3/4 went in a flat 111. Jesse Kimball says go to Nate's Mineshaft, who carries a 5-length lead in the final furlong. Mission Impossible fully stretched. Pants on fire fully stretched. Toby's Corner is next in back of Nate's Mineshaft. Jesse Kimball for Austin K. Smith and the New Orleans Handicap.
Nate's Mineshaft by Lane's Inn Stallion Mineshaft draws off to defeat Mission Impossible by 7.25 lengths. Jesse Kimball aboard in track record time of 147.3, a 107 brisk speed rating. The 4th consecutive victory for Nate's Mineshaft, who has won 4 of 5 since Austin Smith took over as trainer. He was coming off a front running score in the Grade 3 Mineshaft Handicap. The 5-year-old Ridgeling was bred in Kentucky by Cobra Farm and was an $8,000 yearling. Nate's Mineshaft has earned $415,000 for Windy Hill Farm. Also from Fairgrounds, the Grade 2 Mervyn H. Munez Jr. Memorial Handicap on turf. Slow Pace, the 5-2 favorite. Once again, here's John Dooley.
Heading to the half-mile pole in the Mervyn Munez Jr. Memorial, and Mr. Vegas leads by a length. Paw Bodie. At the inside, Willie Kunker looking to come through as they go to the far side of the Fairgrounds course. Slow Pace is 3 from the front. Then Casino Host out deep on the course. Smart Bit is saving ground. Swift Warrior has 6 lengths to raise. 3 furlongs to go now. Wilkinson toward the inside now moving up. Then comes Join 'em. Sun Tracer has trailed. Mr. Vegas has led. Mr. Vegas a length in front. And Mr. Vegas now going all in for the quarter pole. And they've turned the corner. Mr. Vegas, Paw Bodie, Casino Host. Toward the inside, Slow Pace. Willie Conquer in a bit tight toward the fence with the orange cap. Far outside, Sun Tracer and Join 'em in the final furlong across the course. Casino Host, Paw Bodie, Mr. Vegas, Slow Pace. Join 'em on the far outside. Smart Bit is in behind these. Inside the final 16th, Casino Host. Casino Host and John Velasquez to win it at 10-1.
Longshot Casino host runs by Pawpaw Bodie to take it by half a length for a 1-2 finish by Keeneland Sells graduates. John Velasquez aboard in 150-4. The first stakes win for casino host, who was coming off an entry-level allowance victory at Gulfstream Park. The 4-year-old colt by Dynaformer was bred in Kentucky by Colts Neck Stables, LLC, and was a $290,000 Keeneland September yearling. Trained by Chad Brown, casino host has earned $396,000 for Gary and Mary West. John Velasquez with the Safe Ride of the Week, presented by Sally Horse Fans, the safest way to the winner's circle. Watch Thoroughbred Week online on the Keeneland website at Keeneland.com. Click on the sales banner, then select video and Thoroughbred Week. Welcome back to Thoroughbred Week with three races for three-year-old fillies in this segment. Three-year-old stakes action is presented by BC2A Paste. Reduce the likelihood of tying up with BC2A Paste. We begin with the Grade 2 Gulfstream Oaks. Grace Hall, the 6-5 favorite. Larry Comas has the call.
47 flat for the half around the far turn. And Yara's joined by Grace Hall. And with 3 furlongs to go, they're on even terms. And Grace Hall pokes ahead in front. Yara battles on. Zoe Impressive is coming with a run. She's the gray on the far outside. At the rail, Hearts of Red is right there. The Cats All That is in between horses. And they're into the stretch. And Grace Hall is the leader. Zoe Impressive. Yara to the inside tries to battle on. But it's Grace Hall, and she's coming to the eighth pole clear. Zoe Impressive doing her best. Yara next on the inside. Grace Hall is pulling away. And Grace Hall and Javier Castellano have dominated their foes in the Gulfstream Oaks.
Grace Hall draws off for a 6.5 length victory over Zoe Impressive. Javier Castellano aboard the Keeneland Sells graduate in 149-1. Winner of the Grade 1 Spinaway Stakes last summer and runner-up to champion My Miss Aurelia in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies, Grace Hall opened her 3-year-old campaign with a neck setback in the Grade 2 Devona Dale Stakes. The filly by Empire Maker was bred in Kentucky by Darley and was a $95,000 Keeneland September yearling. Trained by Tony Dutrow, Grace Hall has earned $809,000 for Michael Dubb, Bethlehem Stables, and the Elkstone Group. Next, the Grade 2 Fairgrounds Oaks. Summer Applause, the 9-10 favorite. John Dooley picks up the call.
Believe you can. Small Kitchen on the outside is edged into second with 3 furlongs to go. The half mile was 46 2/5 seconds. Through the far turn, Believe You Can in front. Small Kitchen now being ridden hard to challenge. Summer Applause comes up on the outside. Colonial Empress will do it early as drop back. Disposable Pleasure fifth as they come past the quarter pole. And it's Believe You Can at the top of the stretch. 3/4 in 1:11-2. Believe You Can coming down to this final Fairgrounds furlong. Believe You Can is 4 lengths in front of Summer Applause, who's trying to bridge the deficit inside the final 16th. Believe You Can, Summer Applause trying hard. Believe You Can, Summer Applause with one last thrust. Believe You Can in the Fairgrounds Oaks.
Believe You Can holds off the late charge of odds on favorite Summer Applause by a head. Rosie Napravnik aboard the Keeneland Sells graduate in 143-4. A Grade 3 stakes winner at 2, Believe You Can opened this season with a victory over Summer Applause in the Silver Bullet Day Stakes. However, in her last start, she finished 4th when her rival captured the Grade 3 Rachel Alexandra Stakes. The filly by Proud Citizen was bred in Kentucky by her owner, Brereton C. Jones. Trained by Larry Jones, Believe You Can has earned $495,000. That brings us to the Grade 1 Santa Anita Oaks. Eden's Moon, the 1-2 favorite. Trevor Denman has the call.
They head to the half-mile pole, and Renee's got Zip. Didn't get any breather out there. They came right back to keep the pressure on her, and she sprints away again. Renee's got Zip in full flight now, opens up 2.5. Eden's Moon is in the second position. On the inside, Willoughby Awesome. Then a gap of 4 lengths further back to Conjure the Spirit, and Ballast Fantasy making hard work of it, ridden along but not doing anything. They are approaching the quarter pole, and Renee's got Zip. Rene's got Zip by just over two. Eden's Moon chasing from second. Willoughby Awesome running a big one in the white cap on the outside. These are the three in the Santa Anita Oaks. Rene's got Zip, digs deep, finds more. Rene's got Zip, Willoughby Awesome chasing gamely. Eden's Moon starting to battle in third. They come for home now. Rene's got Zip, Willoughby Awesome closing inches on the outside. Rene's got Zip, breathing fire but hanging on. Rene's got Zip, Willoughby Awesome, Willoughby Awesome. Rene's got Zip in a thriller.
And let's take another look at the tightest finish of the week. It's Rene's Got Zip with the lead under Garrett Gomez. But 13-1 long shot Willoughby Awesome is flying down the middle of the track with Martin Pedroza up. Both fillies toting 122 pounds. And Willoughby Awesome gets up to take the photo by a nose. Odds on favorite Eden's Moon settles for third. Barrett Sells graduate Willoughby Awesome clocked in 142-2. Winner of the Barrett's Debutante Stakes at 2, Willoughby Awesome stepped up to take the Grade 3 Santa Isabel Stakes in her 3-year-old debut. However, in her last start, she finished 4th when Eden's Moon captured the Grade 1 Las Virginas Stakes. The California-bred filly by Awesome Gambler was an $18,000 Barrett's January 2-year-old. Trained by Walter Solis, Willoughby Awesome has earned nearly $429,000 for the partnership of Phil Daniels, Patsy London, John Winters, and breeder Terry Lovinger. The Lanes and Stallion of the Week is Grade 1 winner Courageous Cat, who is standing his first season. Courageous Cat, who finished second to the Great Gold Dakova in the Breeders' Cup Mile, is a son of Storm Cat and Grade 1 winner Tranquility Lake. Call today to book a season to the good-looking and very fast Courageous Cat. Welcome back to Thoroughbred Week with the Grade 1 Florida Derby just ahead of this segment. But first to Fairgrounds for the Grade 2 Louisiana Derby. The entry of Mr. Bowling and Mark Valesky favored at 3-2. Once again, here's John Dooley.
Comiskey's Humor leads the way from Hero of Order. Cigar Street is third. At the inside, Windsurfer Saving Ground in fourth. Mark Valesky in the clear fifth and five from the front. In between horses, Share Property and the Red Cap. Z Dagger, Rousing Sermon is out wide. Then a Ford, Fire Alarm. We come back in the field then to Out Wide, Flashy Sunrise. Mr. Bowling also in and amongst those back markers with Finnegan's Wake and the half mile in 47 1/5 seconds. And Hero of Order, the first to go for home. Hero of Order in front, Cigar Street, Mark Valesky now coming on the outside and coming well. Windsurfer, Comiskey's Humor is dropped back as they come past the quarter pole. Shared Property on the far outside, and now they're at the top of the stretch. Mark Valesky charging at Hero of Order, Cigar Street between horses, Shared Property, Rousing Sermon, then comes Windsurfer. They're deep in the final furlong. Hero of Order at astronomical odds. Mark Valesky, Cigar Street, coming down toward the wire. Hero of Order, Mark Valesky, in an absolute Louisiana Derby shocker.
Long shot Hero of Order at odds of 109-1 holds off Mark Valesky by half a length for a 1-2 finish by Keeneland Sells graduates. Eddie Martin Jr. aboard in 150 flat. Only the second victory in 14 starts for Hero of Order, who broke his maiden sprinting 6 furlongs over the track in his seasonal debut. He was coming off a second place finish in the Black Gold Stakes over the Fairgrounds turf course. The colt was bred in Kentucky by Windhill Farm. The winner is owned and trained by former Russian jockey Gennady Dorochenko. Hero of Order has earned $657,000 for Route LLC. The colt was consigned by Denali stud, Craig and Holly Banderoff agent, to the 2010 Keeneland September yearling sale, where he was purchased by Kazakoff, agent for Route LLC, for a bargain $3,000. Louisiana Derby winner Hero of Order, the Keeneland Sales graduate of the week. To Gulfstream Park for the Grade 1 Florida Derby. Union Rags, the 2-5 favorite. Once again, here's Larry Colmus.
Up the backstretch, a 47-3 half mile for Take Charge Indy, who's been in front since the gates opened. Rev Her Own pursues in second, and then it's neck and neck. El Padrino, Union Rags, in behind horses. He's in fifth. He's five lengths off the lead. Fort Loudon just passed him. News Pending is next, and then Z Camelot. Around the far turn, it is still Take Charge Indy. Rev Her Own now neck and neck, comes off the rail and makes a three wide run. El Padrino goes four deep. Fort Loudon is next, and Union Rags is still sixth. He's in behind horses. He's three lengths off the lead. Julian Leperu will have to make a decision where to go. He's going to bring him to the inside, and they're into the stretch, and it's still Take Charge Indy and Rev Her Own, and Union Rags is down on the inside. He's making his run. Can he get there? And then it's El Padrino. It's still Take Charge Indy, Rev Her Own. Union Rags switches to the outside, but Take Charge Indy wins the Florida Derby, wire to wire under Calvin Burrell.
Calvin Burrell, who has ridden three of the last five Kentucky Derby winners as a live mount for this year's Derby, as Take Charge Indy scores the front running victory by a length over Rev Her Own. A 1-2 finish by Keeneland Sells graduates. Time of the race, 1:48-3. The regally bred colt impressively broke his maiden first asking at Arlington Park last summer, but had lost his last four starts. He was runner-up to El Padrino in a Gulfstream allowance test in his three-year-old debut. The colt by AP Indy, out of multiple Grade 1 stakes winner and $2 million earner Take Charge Lady, was bred in Kentucky by Eaton Sales. Trained by Patrick Byrne, Take Charge Indy has earned $721,000 for Chuck and Mary Beth Sanford. Now to John and Joel of TCI with this week's Triple Crown Insight, presented by Escondrea, standing at TaylorMade Farm.
This week on TCI, we discuss the Wood Memorial, the Santa Anita Derby, and also the Illinois Derby. Joel, this is the time of year where it's all about graded earnings.
It really is, John. Just look at last weekend. We had the $1 million Louisiana Derby, and your winner, Hero of Order, he won $600,000. That would have normally got him into the starting gate of the Derby. However, it won't, because the horse isn't Triple Crown nominated, so he's most likely not going to get in. And what that does is it opens the window for the horses running this weekend that need the graded earnings in these three big races. And we have some big-time names.
Well, let's just mention two of them real quick. We got Gemologist and also Alpha in the Wood Memorial.
Yeah, and I'll Have Another is another horse, John. There's several of them that have proven to be talented and fast but need the graded earnings. And then what's interesting to me is you have horses like Mark Valesky, El Padrino, disappointed this weekend. They're hoping that the favorites win. They're hoping Creative Cause, horses that are already in, get the money. In that case, they have a better chance of making the Derby field.
All right, thank you, Joel. Make sure you guys come back next week on Thoroughbred Week. We'll discuss the Arkansas Derby and the Bluegrass Stakes.
The Dubai World Cup is coming up, but first, here are the top 10 Brisk Speed ratings run by three-year-olds this year. Time now for the feature race of the week, presented by Keeneland, investing in racing's future since 1936. It's the $10 million Dubai World Cup. The field included champion mare Royal Delta and Bob Baffert trained Game On Dude. Here's the call by Terry Spargo.
800 meters in 49.9. There's no loafing. There's no room for squibs. Capone's moved up 3D. Out of the back, and Capone takes the lead. So You Think has the rail. Transcend in the middle. Game On Dude out wide, continuing to improve. Then Monterosso, Master of Hounds, Planter, followed by Zazu, Royal Delta, Prince Bishop, Asian Flash, and Smart Falcon is the last to swing. Capone leads for home. There's room for So You Think on the rail. Monterosso third, and they broke away from Planter. Monterosso goes up to Capone, 250 meters out. Monterosso takes the lead from Capone. Planter's running on, but Monterosso's broken clear in the cup. 100 meters left to go. Monterosso driven out, is clear of Capone. Planter and So You Think. Mikhail does it again, because Monterosso's won the cup.
The boys in blue finish 1-2 as Monterosso defeats his Godolphin stablemate Capone by three lengths. Jockey Mikhail Barcelona giving the winner a standing ovation nearing the finish. Time of the race, 2:02-3. The sixth winner of the Dubai World Cup for Dubai ruler Sheikh Mohammed Al Maktoum, Monterosso had made only one start since finishing third in the 2011 running. That was a fourth place finish at the Group 1 Sheikh Mohammed Challenge won by Capone. Mamoun Al-Zarouni trains both Monterosso and Capone. The English-bred five-year-old horse by Dabawi is a grandson of Sheikh Mohammed's 2000 Dubai World Cup winner, Dubai Millennium. With the winner's share of $6 million, Monterosso has a bankroll of $7.4 million. We'll see you next week here on Thoroughbred Week.
Thoroughbred Week with John Henderson has been presented by Adena Springs, Ashford Stud, BC2A Paste, Bloodstock Research, Breeders' Cup, Claiborne Farm, GLC 5500, Gainesway, Horse Sense, Keeneland, Lane's Inn, Malone's, OCD Pellets, Pin Oak Stud, Quillen Leather and Tack, Spendthrift Farm, Thoroughbred Times, Warrendale Sales, and Woods Edge Farm. Produced by John Henderson in association with Scott Ryan.